only my life, but the life of my family. Now, you see, I had not seen my family all of this time. I was not welcome there. But would you say my father and my mother and my brother and my sisters and their family? The tall, dark one looked at me, and I said, it's only fair. And he said, yes. In exchange, our lives for your lives and your families. Now, he said, that is only fair. And they must be in this inn. Agreed, I said. I will see that they're here. If they're outside, they will not be spared. I agree that they will be here. Now, I said, eat quickly, and I will let you down over the wall. Now, I had been weaving flax, and I took my longest rope of flax, and I let them down over the wall. And then as they were going down the wall, Solomon said, and you must keep this cord here so that we can identify where you are. Agreed. Now, I said, you see those mountains over there? Go to those mountains and stay for 3 days. And then you may go back to your camp. Oh, I couldn't wait till the next morning. You see, I had not been at my home. For me to be on the streets was unsafe. With my face covered, I went to my home, not even knocking, bursting in. And I said, I want you to know that Jericho is to be destroyed. Everyone, every man, woman, child, and animal will be killed. I have not known much about this Jehovah, but I know he is the supreme being. And I do know that Jericho is to be destroyed. Now, I have a way of escape if you will all come to the inn. My father said, everyone? I said, yes, everyone. But I do have a way if you will come to the inn. My mother turned her back on her unholy daughter. What seemed like an eternity, my knees were knocking. I was shaking all over. I said, you must come to the inn. My brothers, my sisters, their children, you must all come and you will be safe. And then my father finally said, we will all be there. I couldn't fight back the tears. There wasn't time for any hugs. Come quickly, I said. I went back to the inn. I put a sign across the door, closed. I dismissed all of my servants. I gave them double in wages, and I gave them jewels. To Nina, who wanted to stay with me, my maid, I said, I didn't make provisions for you. Go before the gate is closed. Jericho is to be destroyed. Now, you see, I had plenty of room for my family, and little by little, they began to come to the inn. Little by little, I could hear them. I made provisions for all of them. And then, the next day, I heard, looking over the side, I saw a strange sight. I saw 7 priests with ram's horns. I saw an oblong box carried by the priest on their shoulders. And behind them, the rear guard. And they marched around the city. The chills were going up and down my arm. They marched around the city once. This was not the day. They went back. Amazing. The next day, the same sound. Again, looking. Oh, I must make sure the scarlet cord is there. Going over to check to see if it was still there. But again, the same procession. The oblong box on the shoulders of the priest. The priest ahead with the ram's horns. Third day. Fourth day. The same thing. Fifth. Sixth. Same thing. But on the seventh day, I had been up to comfort one of my nephews who was crying, and it was before light, and I heard the marching. Oh, I knew this was the day. This had to be the day. They had never come back early before. I couldn't even see, but I knew it would be the same procession. And by this time, everyone was awake. One of my nephews began to count. They went around once, and then he counted twice. We took our lunch on top of the roof to watch. Suddenly, I felt something around my waist. I looked around, and it was my mother, and we embraced. There was no time to say I'm sorry. Only that we knew today was a day that we might not live through. 5 times. 6 times. My nephew kept shouting the times, and the 7th time he shouted 7, and they went around again, and the ram's horns began to blow. Oh, it was an eerie sound of the priest blowing the ram's horns, and then Joshua shouted, "Shout!" And all of the people shouted, and the impregnable walls of Jericho began to sway like a rag doll. And then the only thing standing was the inn on the wall. Oh, we all huddled together as the soldiers came in, killing every man, woman, child. We hid the eyes of my nieces and nephews. I went again to see if the cord was still there. It was still there. We were all trembling, knowing that our lives were in danger. Finally, I heard my name, Rahab. Yes, yes. Are you all here? Yes, we're all here. Come quickly, he said. This part of the wall will be going down soon. Follow me quickly. Everyone else went. I took one of the children's arms, a bag, and the other that we had packed. Over the rubble, which you could not believe. Out of breath on the other side. Suddenly, to get our breath, I had to sit down, and I heard a grinding. And then I looked back, and the grinding of the wall, which had been my home for 3 years, and a scarlet robe flying in the air. My whole life gone. And Solomon looked at me and he said, "You don't look like a prostitute." I said, "I'm not married." And when he walked away, you see, my family and I could not go into the camp yet because we were not believers completely in Jehovah God. And when he walked away, I said, "I'm going to marry you." Now, he didn't hear it. And you men don't stand the chance. And you know what? I did marry him. Do any of you know our son's name? Boaz. Boaz came home one day and he said, "Mother, I think I'm in love with a heathen woman." I said, "Son, you're looking at one that used to be." Now, folks, I call my story Rahab, a God of a second chance. I don't know what you've done in your past, but I do know this. You take Rahab, a prostitute, and Rahab became the bloodline of your Jesus. What more forgiveness of a second chance from a prostitute to the bloodline of a man called Jesus? So whatever you have done in your life, I want you to know that you serve a God of a second chance. And remember my story. Will you pray with me? Father, what better forgiveness than to know from the bloodline of Jesus Christ that came from a woman named Rahab, who was a prostitute. Father, I don't know those in the sound of my voice who think that God could not forgive them for their past. Will they remember the story of this morning, that you are a God who forgives?